heard of the blind harper, how he lived in Lochmaben town. He would go to fair England to steal King Henry's wanton brown. But first he's gone unto his wife with all the speed that he could show. This work, he says, it'll never go well without the help of our good grey mare. She says, you take the good grey mare, she'll run o'er hills both low and high. Sit you on the grey mare's back and leave the foal at home with me. So he is up to England gone, even as fast as go could he. When he came to Carlisle gates, who should be there but King Henry? And the king, he looked over his left shoulder, and he says unto his serving groom, take the poor blind harper's mare, put her beside me wanton brown. And then he sang, and he charmed them all so fast asleep. Straightway he took off his shoes, quietly down the stairs did creep. Soon he came to the stable door, with tread as light could be. When he opened and went in, he found 30 steeds and three. And he's taken a halter from his hose, and from his purpose he did not fail. He slipped it over the wanton's nose, he's tied it to the grey mare's tail. And he's loosed them out of the castle gates, and the mare didn't fail to find her way. She was at Lochmaben town 3 long hours before the day. And the very next morning in broad daylight, when they had ended all their cheer, behold, the wanton brown was gone, likewise the poor blind harper's mare. And it's oh, and alas, says the blind harper, and it's ever and alas that I came here. In Scotland I've lost me a good grey foal, in England they've stolen me old grey mare. And it's hold you talking, you blind harper, and again of your music let us hear. Well paid shall your coat foal be, you will have a far better mare. So the harper harped, and then he sang, so sweet was the music he let them hear. He was paid for a foal that he never had lost, 3 times over for the good grey mare. And listen to my story. It's about noble Stewball, that gallant racing pony. Arthur Marble was the man that first brought Stewball here, but to run with Miss Greasel on the plains of Kildare. And the fame of his actions we've heard of before, but now he is challenged by young Mrs. Gore to run with Miss Greasel, that handsome grey mare, the 10,000 gold guineas on the plains of Kildare. And the cattle they were brought out with saddle, whip and bridle. The gentleman did shout at the sight of the gallant riders in viewing the cattle just as they came there. Oh, they all laid their money on the Monaghan grey mare. And the order it was given and away they did fly. Stewball
snowball like an arrow, the grey mare passed by. If you had been there to have seen them going round, you'd have thought to your heart the feet ne'er touched the ground. And when at last they came to halfway round the course, Stewball and his rider began to discourse. Says Stewball to the rider, "Can you tell to me how far is that grey mare this moment from me?" Says the rider to Stewball, "You're running great style. You're ahead of the grey mare almost half a mile. If you keep your running, I vow and I swear that you never will be beaten by the Monaghan grey mare." All passed it quite handy. Horse and rider both called for cherry wine and brandy. They drank up a health to the noble grey mare, but she emptied their pockets on the plains of Kildare.
I roved out on a bright May morning to view the meadows and flowers gay. Whom should I spy but my own true lover, as she sat under yon willow tree. I took off my hat and I did salute her. I did salute her most courageously. When she turned around, well, the tears fell from her, saying, "False young man, you have deluded me. A diamond ring I own I gave you, a diamond ring to wear on your right hand. But the vows you made, love, you went and broke them, and married the lassie that had the land. If I married the lassie that had the land, my love, it's that I'll rue until the day I die. When misfortune falls, no man can shun it. I was a blindfolded, I'll ne'er deny. Now at night, so when I go to my bed of slumber, the thoughts of my true love run in my mind. When I turn around to embrace my darling, instead of gold, sure 'tis brass I find. And I wish the queen would call home her army from the West Indies, America and Spain, and every man to his wedded woman, in hopes that you and I will meet again. Thank you.
It being on one Monday morning, it being our payday, we met Sergeant Jenkins at our going away. He says to Pat Reilly, "You are a handsome young man. Will you come to John Kelly's where we will get a dram?" And while we sat there boozing and drinking his dram, he says to Pat Reilly, "You are a handsome young man. I'd have you take the bounty and come along with me to the sweet county Longford. Strange faces there you'll see." "Oh no, kind sir, a soldier's life with me would not agree, nor neither would I bind myself down from my liberty. For I lived as happy as a prince, my mind does tell me so. So fare thee well, I'm just going down my shuttle for to throw. Oh, are you in a hurry? Are you going away? Or won't you stop and listen to these words I'm going to say? Perhaps now, Pat Reilly, you might do something worse than to leave your native country and enlist in the Black Horse." Oh, and so I took the bounty, the reckoning was paid, the ribbons were brought out, me boys, and pinned to my cockade. It's early the next morning, we all were made to stand before our grand general with hats all in our hands. Pat Reilly, you are a little too low. With some other regiment, I fear you have to go. I may go where I will, I have no one to mourn. My mother is dead, me boys, and never will return. It's not in the morning that I sing my song, but it's in the cold evening as I march alone. My gun or my shoulder, I bitterly do weep when I think of my true love that now lies fast asleep. My blessing on my mother that reared me neat and clean, but bad luck to my father that made me serve the queen. Oh, had he been an honest man and learned me my trade, I would never have listed nor worn the cockade.
Băneasă's green forest out under the trees, we'd lie on our backs, we'd live at our ease. We'd wake in the morning at the first shafts of day and watch the shy deer as they scampered away. We'd rise from our warm beds as the sun it got higher and cook up our breakfasts on a sweet-scented fire. Morning, a a cool, gentle breeze. The echo of woodpeckers rings through the trees. We'd sit in our glade till the heat of the day. Walk down to the zoo to sing and to play. Well, the money rolled in, and the people looked on. When the hat was quite full, we'd up and begun. In Gamber Beats, a tavern, we drank money free, and drank to our friends, where'er they may be. Old times and fond memories we'd trade, and at dusk we'd walk home to Băneasă's green glade.